chosen for himself as high priest, and opening his treasure house made him rich in all good things. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Your brothers and sisters gathering on this Friday, we do so as we celebrate this memorial of St. Damasus I, who was the Pope of the late 4th century, so right at the time of the new public expression of the faith, and one who having established with Christianity in Rome, now being able to be more freely expressed, began the very process of bringing to Rome that sense of unity, that sense of oneness in the Catholic faith, which is universal, but bringing it to that place of particular dedication to the lives of the martyrs and the witness of the saints. So, dear brothers and sisters, recognizing too that we are called to that universal call to holiness, to be martyrs if need be, to be saints every day, let us acknowledge our sins and prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Have mercy on us, O Lord.
For we have sinned against you.
Show us, O Lord, your mercy.
And grant us your salvation.
And Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Grant we pray, O Lord, that we may constantly exalt the merits of your martyrs, whom Pope St. Damasus so venerated and loved, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to the crowds, "To what shall I compare this generation? It is like children who sit in marketplaces and call to one another, "We played the flute for you, but you did not dance. We sang a dirge, but you did not mourn." For John came, neither eating nor drinking, and they said, "He is possessed by a demon." The Son of Man came, eating and drinking, and they said, "Look, he is a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners." But wisdom is vindicated by her works. The Gospel of the Lord. I, the Lord your God, teach you what is for your good, and lead you on the way you should go. Thus says the Lord your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. I, the Lord your God, teach you what is for your good, and lead you on the way you should go. As we celebrate this Holy Mass, as we go about each and every day, as we consider the very fact of our lives, do we understand ourselves to be on the way to holiness? Do we understand ourselves to be on the way to coming to know the Lord our God? And if we find that we have already encountered him in some particular way in our life, whether it's the great joy of marriage and childbirth, the rearing of family children and raising of families, or if we have encountered him in some particular instance of illness or sickness, some recovery in particular need, or the mourning the loss of a loved one, we've come to a deeper sense of the things transitory and the things eternal. Do we recognize in these different episodes of our life, and not just in the particular ones, the ones that stand out, but in each and every day, that we are working out our holiness, that we are working out our union with God? Heaven is nothing other than perfect union with God. And if you come to Mass regularly, if you come to Mass, especially on Sundays as we are called to, if you read sacred scripture every day, if you pray the rosary and certain devotions, do you know you are fostering that union with God? And if perhaps that union with God feels a little off, then what is it that we are doing, or what is it that we are hoping for in the pursuit of that union with God? Do we judge according to our feelings? Oh, I feel peace, that must be God. Or I don't feel peace and everything seems to be going wrong. Well, God must be far from me. Is he though? So how do we judge our relationship with the Lord? As the Lord Jesus himself says, "To what shall I compare this generation? It is like children who sit in marketplaces and call to one another. We played the flute for you, but you didn't dance. We sang a dirge, but you did not mourn." As though we are unaware of how to relate with one another and how to read, as it were, the signs of those relationships. But there is a great relationship between heaven and earth, mediated through Christ Jesus. There is a great relationship between heaven and earth as experienced by saints in history and saints of today. Those who are struggling with the same struggles that you and I endure. You are not alone in the work of your holiness. You are not alone on the way of salvation. For indeed we find ourselves here together today. And so as we continue this work, as we continue along the way, let us ask ourselves, how do we know that God is near? And how can I look to my brothers and sisters in the work of my holiness? Amen. Lord Jesus, you come to meet us in the very ways of our lives. And so we ask that you help us recognize you and to know that you are ever interceding on our behalf, bringing us closer to yourself.
For leaders in the church, may they be guided by God's wisdom in all they do. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For local, national, and world leaders, may God give them the grace to move away from any hypocrisy and be guided instead by truth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those traveling the long road of grief, may they know Christ's presence and rest in the confidence that nothing can separate us from the love of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this community of faith, may we be empowered by the Holy Spirit in living our unique call to holiness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died in the light of faith, may they rest in the presence of God, and especially today, we remember Harold Melendez. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers written in our Book of Remembrance, those we have been asked to pray for, and those we lift up from the depths of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Merciful and loving Father,
we ask to be like children who are eager to trust in you, who are eager to rejoice in your presence, through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept this sacrifice from your people, we pray, O Lord, and make what is offered for your glory in honor of Blessed Damasus a means to our eternal salvation through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Damasus you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, William, our Bishop-elect, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Damasus, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Body of Christ. Receive the communion of the Holy Spirit. Receive the communion of the Holy Spirit. The body of Christ. body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. 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 The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. Receive the communion of the Holy Spirit. Receive the communion of the Holy Spirit. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Body of Christ. The 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 Good Shepherd has laid down his life for his sheep.
This food, O Lord, may possess in purity of heart, that what has been given to us in time may be healing for eternity.
Let us pray. May the sacraments we have received, O Lord our God, stir up in us that fire of charity with which blessed Damasus burned ardently as he gave himself unceasingly for your church, through Christ our Lord. Just a final invitation on this Friday regarding our praise and worship tomorrow night. Know that all are welcome, and certainly an opportunity for adoration of the Most Blessed Sacrament with music and encouragement in that way, as well as the availability of confessions. So please know that it will be a wonderful evening tomorrow night from 7 to 8:30 for our praise and worship here at St. John's. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, Immaculate Heart of Mary, Pope Saint Damasus the First, Saint John the Evangelist, all holy men and women, pray for us.